girls, let's get our lab coats on before we start. Quickly. What did we do last lesson?
Learned about what's in an atom.
What's in an atom? What makes up an atom? What makes up an atom, Lily?
Protons, neutrons, and electrons.
Electrons. My name's Jennifer Croden, and I teach maths and science at St Mary's College. I'm also the year coordinator for Year 8. We've started chemistry a few weeks ago, leading up to this, because we had to start with saying that chemistry is all around us. Matter is everything that takes up space, and then we had to go to the basics. So, you know, atoms, then we had to talk about the structure, and then eventually we got into making compounds out of the elements. Helium, can you please be the director and make them into the helium atom?
Okay, so it's two of each, so two protons.
So protons, how are they going to be positive? What are you going to use? Hands up, smiley, yes.
And then two neutrons. You're all close together because you're...
So give them enough room to run around.
Okay, do you remove it? And now electrons. You need to run 3 times the speed of light.
At 3/4 the speed of?
I thought it was 3 times.
3/4. Oh. So guys, are they going 3/4 the speed of light? No, they need to practice their running skills. Now girls, I would love to say we can make our own fireworks, but we can't. Why can't we? Yes?
Dangerous.
They're quite dangerous. But we can make the colours. These girls turn certain colours. Like fireworks, they turn certain colours. So remember, when we are spraying these, we don't need a lot of the solution for the colour to appear. So when we're spraying these, obviously maybe just spray it out this way, okay? Goggles should be on, that's already what we're doing wrong, and hair should be tied up. We do need to be wearing the appropriate gear. They always have closed-in shoes, so we never need to worry about that. The hair's always tied back. It's just more lab coats, lab glasses. Safety data sheets tell you about the properties of the chemicals. It just tells you what to do if they ingest it, if they inhale, or even how dangerous it is in those areas, if there's a spillage and disposal. So it gives you a brief outline, and by the time you've been working a few years, you sort of get a guide of what the ones are to look out for and the ones that are okay, and having that science background helps with that. Obviously, because I know my class quite well now, I know how to engage them.
So if we were to like have like a gas flame or something, then we spray salt water, it would do that?
It would do the yellow, yeah, absolutely, that bright yellow. Yeah. What's the metallic element in cobalt chloride?
I've got
yeah.
Cobalt.
Yep, go for it, girls. Obviously, there was many different colours, and some looked quite similar to others. But the two unknowns was your main aim. Maggie, unknown two, what did it look like to you?
Unknown two, it looked like a brighty green colour.
Bright green colour. Hands up if you had a green colour come up in your experiment for unknown two. Oh, wow. We're all right. Well done, that's exactly what you should have got. And the green colour represents which salt?
Copper chloride.
Yeah, nothing left, what is it?
Copper chloride.
Well, to be honest, a lot of my lessons are similar in structure in the sense that we go over last lesson quickly. We then go, okay, we're doing this, which is directly related to last lesson. We may talk about it, engage the students, and then we might do some notes on it. Do a prac and then do a write-up. It varies, obviously, a little bit from that. But why I did it that way would be just because students learn in different ways. And a lot of students actually love doing the theory and writing down the notes and reading, and that's how they learn, and that's fantastic. But a lot of my other students are much more hands-on and are very good verbally. So I think you need to accommodate for all levels, and even aesthetically. So with visuals and doing mini drama sort of sessions, I think all of those combined, you're catering for the majority of students.